with confidence. Look at somebody in their face and say, He will do it for you. He will do it for you. Come on Tuesday. I'm waiting for Tuesday. Look at somebody and say, I'm waiting for Tuesday. I'm waiting for Tuesday. Hallelujah. By Tuesday, everything is going to be all right. You just decreed it and declared it out of your mouth that everything is going to be all right. That He's able. Hallelujah. Is there an able praise in the house? Is there an able praise in the house? I'm not going to provoke you. Is there an able praise in the house? Is there an able praise in the house? Is there an able praise in the house? Hallelujah. Is there an able praise in the house? You know an able God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, the presence of the Lord is heavy in here. Hallelujah. A lot of people been going through with your bodies. You've been in car accidents, you've been hurt, sicknesses, everything. But your healing is here. Look at somebody say, the healer is here. The healer is here. You don't need a cure because the healer is here. Hallelujah. The healer is in the atmosphere. I need you to put your hand up for your healing right on down. And place it where you need to have it. Hallelujah. 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 I'm expecting this thing. Hallelujah. I made a deposit with my praise. So this week when I really need a healing, I can just pull it on down and place it on my leg. I can pull it on down and place it on my head. I can pull it on down and place it on my heart. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. You got to put a praise fit on it. Put a down praise fit on it. Whatever you need, I need to put a praise on it. Glory to God. great thing he's going to do if you give him praise right now. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And we give God praise this morning. Hallelujah. We're now going to turn this portion of the service over to the speaker of the hour, who is none other than Minister Karan Maddox. Amen.
Amen.
Can we just honor praise unto the Lord? Amen. Can we just love one another? Hallelujah, you understand. Father, I thank you. God, we give you glory. Father, we praise your name in your temple. God, we honor you, God. Oh, most high God, we thank you for the day, Father. We thank you for the sunshine. We thank you for just to be in your house. We thank you for your presence, God. We thank you that the blood still works, God. We thank you, oh God, for healing, God. We thank you for the power in your word, God. We give you glory, Father. We praise your name, God. Oh God, we honor your presence today, Father, that you go into your word, God. I pray that you will speak, God. Oh God, in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord God, put me aside and in the spirit of the living God speak, Father. In the name of Jesus Christ, speak into our hearts and our minds and our ears, God, that we may hear and understand and able to apply your word, God. In the name of Jesus Christ, oh God, give us a word today, Father. Oh God, you know we all stand in the need of Almighty God. So God, we pray that you will give us a word, Father. Speak to our very situation, God. Speak to our very circumstance, Father. Speak to our very life being, God. And God, just have your way, God. And I believe myself, God. And the spirit of living God may take over in the name of Jesus Christ. And the words of my mouth, the meditation of my heart, be something on thy sight. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank God.
Amen.
Amen. And as you take your seat, can you clap your hands and can you tell the Lord, thank you. Giving honor to God, amen. And to our general overseer, my bishop, our co-pastor, amen. God is wonderful, isn't he? Amen. And Brother David, our presider today, hallelujah. Everybody, all the young people, amen. Everybody in God's house. God is an awesome God. Amen. He's an awesome God. Do you mind if I just shout hallelujah just for a second? Think of his goodness, amen. All he's done for me, I was just reminded of something last week when my mother and my mom was in a car accident. I began to say, God, I thank you that the enemy can't come through the blood. Hallelujah. He can try to penetrate, but he cannot come through the blood. Melinda, I'm so grateful, hallelujah, that the devil can't come through the blood. Hallelujah. But he can come near it. He can try to penetrate, but he can't come through the blood. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. So when I think of his goodness and all that he's done, my soul cries out, hallelujah. No matter what plot or plan the enemy or scheme the enemy may come up with to try to come to you, just know that he cannot come through the blood. He can't come near, he can't come out of dwelling. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I reminded what David said. He said, who is this uncircumcised Philistine that you would defy the name of the Lord? Don't you know who I am? Hallelujah. Don't you know who I represent? Don't you know who called me? Hallelujah. Hey. Glory to God. But after you think you're bad, come on. Hallelujah. Because I'm covered in the blood. I'm covered in power. I'm covered. Hallelujah. He got me covered. Glory to God. He got me covered. Hallelujah. No matter which way I go, he got me covered. Hallelujah. So yeah, I'm going forth in the battle because God got me covered. Hallelujah. I'm going forth to do what he called because God, he got me covered. He's got me covered. He's my strength. He's got me on the right side. He got me on the left side. He got me behind. He got me in front. He's got me covered. Hallelujah. That's our word today. He's got us covered. So young people, as we go back to school, amen, how many started school already? Some went back last week, some go back this week. I want you to know that God's got you covered. He's got you covered. You can go ahead and turn to Joshua chapter 1. He's got you covered. We live in the days and times we often think that we're the only ones going through, amen?
Hey,
you know, sometimes we, you know, it's all about me, and I'm the only one going through. Ain't nobody else going through nothing. It's just me. Amen. But I just want to let y'all know that our young people go through just like you do. Amen. Amen. What goes on in your household affects them as well. Amen. What goes on in your household, it affects the young people. What goes on in school, it affects them. Amen. It bothers them. Amen. They may not act out the way you act out, but it bothers them. They're affected by it. And what's going on in this world, they're affected by it too. Because down to the elementary age, they're teaching gender identification. And I'm not telling you something that's so deep that the Lord just, I'm telling you something that's really happening. That's really happening in our elementary schools. Where our first and second graders are given books to practice their reading. And you have boys wearing dresses in the books. They're encouraging gender identification. So what's going on in this world is affecting your child down to the kindergarten age. So it's very prevalent. Young people that we pray is very more prevalent. Parents that we pray over our kids, and we pray. Just remember that it can't come through the blood. And if you just gotta lay your hands on their head and say, "I plead the blood of Jesus over their mind, over their focus, that nothing will come nigh their dwelling, that nothing will affect their thinking, that nothing will allow them to think that it's right when it's wrong." In the name of Jesus, you just got to plead the blood over your children. And young people, while you're walking out the door, lay your hands on your mind and say, "I plead the blood, I plead the blood, I plead the blood." If you got to do it quietly while you're on the bus, "I plead the blood, I plead the blood." Glory to God. I don't want nothing trying to change my mind. Scripture, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. I have a Christ Jesus type mind, and I don't want nothing to change that, so I got to plead the blood of Jesus daily. Upon my mind, upon my attitude, the words that I say. Oh, maybe that's just me. Amen. But he's got us covered. He's got us covered. Amen. We don't have to worry. We can be courageous. Amen. In Joshua chapter 1, verses 1 through 9. "Now after the death of Moses, the servant of the Lord, it came to pass that the Lord spake unto Joshua, the son of Nun, Moses' minister, saying, 'Moses, my servant, is dead. Now therefore arise and go over this Jordan, thou and all this people, unto the land which I do give to them, even to the children of Israel, every place that the sole of your foot shall tread upon, that I have given unto you, as I have said unto Moses, from the wilderness and this Lebanon, even unto the great river, the river Euphrates, all the land of the Hittites, and unto the great sea towards the going down of the sun shall be your coast. There shall not be any man able to stand before thee all the days of my life. And as I was with Moses, so I will be with thee. I will not fail thee, nor forsake thee." Amen. Verse 6 says, "Be strong." Somebody say strong.
Strong.
"And of a good what?
Courage.
Of a good what?
Courage.
For unto this people shalt thou divide for an inheritance the land which I swear unto their fathers to give them. Only be thou what?
Strong.
Only be thou what? And very what?
Courageous.
That thou mayest observe to do according to all the law which Moses my servant commanded thee. Turn not from it to the right hand, nor to the left. Don't turn from it. Don't turn. That thou mayest prosper with it soever thou goest." When you turn, you affect your future, so don't turn from it. "This book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate." Somebody say meditate.
Meditate.
Somebody say meditate.
Meditate.
Meditate therein day and night, that thou mayest do what? Observe. Somebody say observe.
Observe.
To do according to all that is written therein, for thou shalt make thy way what?
Prosperous.
That thou shalt have good what?
Success.
Have not I commanded thee to be what?
Strong.
Oh, come on, say it like you mean. To be what?
Strong.
Look at your neighbor and say, be what? And of a good courage, be what? Not afraid. Be not afraid, neither be thou dismayed, for the Lord thy God is with thee, whithersoever thou goest. Wherever you go, young people and adults alike, God is with us.
Amen.
Amen. We can count on that. We can stomp our foot on that one. Amen. We can run out the door and run back in on that one. And God is with us. Wherever we go, Lord, just we stay on that right road. The scripture said, don't turn from the right, don't turn to the right, don't turn to the left. Keep your focus forward. Amen. But when you do that, you want to have good success. And your way will become prosperous, meaning you will overcome. Amen. The journey that lies ahead you know what? If you go back to Deuteronomy 31, you will find out where Moses, the Lord told Moses that, you know, you're not going to cross over. And Moses called the people together, called Joshua, about 120 years old. And this is it for me. But y'all got to keep going. Joshua's going to lead you. And he told them back then to be strong and of a good carriage. And I was wondering when I was studying, I said, why to be strong and why to be of a good carriage? Because if you read on to Joshua 1, you will find out that after Joshua told the people what the Lord has said, he said, get the fighters. Get the men, get them ready, because we get ready to go forth. Because in 3 days, we're going to cross over to Jordan. Amen. And we're going to face some stuff. We're going to face some battles. So I need you to be courageous. I need you to be strong. Because you're going to face somebody that's going to try to persuade you to do something else. But I need you to not only be courageous, but to be what? Very courageous. Very courageous. He put emphasis on that. Very courageous. They're going to try to get you to do something wrong. They're going to try to get you to smoke weed. They may try to get you to drink or to have sex or to do this or do that. But I need you to be very courageous. Amen. Get the courage to say no.
That's right.
Get the courage to say no, young people. Get the courage to say no. I know it may be a new school for you, a new grade level. Some may be just starting college or going back to college adults of life. Amen. Get the courage to say no. When they try to get you to do wrong, get the courage to say no. Amen. It's all right to do the right thing. Can I say that again? It's all right to do the right thing. That's not the wrong with getting honor on all four boys. That's what you're supposed to do. It's all right to do the right thing. It's all right to be the good one in class. That's sitting there doing his homework, doing the schoolwork, and paying attention to the teacher. That's what you're supposed to do. And nothing wrong with it. So I need you young people that also like to be strong. And very courageous. Very courageous. Adults, we need this word too. But while we at work and while we're going to and fro, running our kids back and forth and doing this and doing that, the enemy's going to try to persuade us to go to the right. He's going to try to persuade us to go to the left. But we got to be strong. We got to be very courageous to tell him no. They're going to try to get us to cut some out, amen. But you got to be courageous. No, I'm not doing that today. I'm not doing it tomorrow either. Matter of fact, I'm not doing it at all. Because I'm strong in who? I'm strong in the Lord. Ephesians said, be strong in the Lord and the power of his mind. The mind of the living God. So we got to be strong. We got to be strong. We got to be strong. He's our strength. He's our strength. In him do I move, live, and have my being. Everything I need, God is there. He is my help. The scripture says he's a very present help. So whenever I'm in danger, he's right there. He's not just present, but he's very present. He's right there. And not only is he, like I said before, not only is he my 911, but he's also my 411. He's also my information when I need wisdom and knowledge and understanding. Because I find that the more that I seek him, the stronger I'm getting. The more time I spend with him, the stronger I'm getting. The more time that I put in with him, the more peace I have. The more time I put in with him, the more love I have. And he enables me to be strong. Young people, you want to get the courage? Because I know sometimes, by show of hands, young people, if you listen to me, who's going to a new school this year? New school. Who's going to a new grade level? New school, new grade level, right. So for those who's going to a new school, even for those who's going to a new grade level, you're going to deal with people you never dealt with before. People you know, you may not know anybody. And even going to a new grade level, you're dealing with work that you may not have never seen before. You're doing a math problem you never done before. You're reading a part of the history book you never read before. When you used to write just one page of what you read, now you gotta rewrite two pages. Because you didn't excel forward. But I want to encourage you that God is with you wherever you go to help you in righteousness. See, the Lord was encouraging Joshua and said, don't turn from the right. Don't turn to the right. And don't turn to the left of what was already said. Hallelujah. You don't need no new principles. You don't need no new word. You already got a word. Hallelujah. You don't need a new story. We already got a story. We got the redemption story. So he said, if you be careful to observe And that word meditate, somebody shout meditate.
Meditate.
Somebody shout meditate.
Meditate.
That means to focus in on. That means after you read, just sit there and just let it just marinate in you. Just let it. You may have to turn on some little worship music and just rehearse the scripture over and over in your mind until you fall asleep. And that word is just going in you, and it just making residence in you. It's becoming a part of you. And that when you need it the most, that word is right there. Why? Because you meditated on it. You not only read the Bible, but you read it till you understood it. You read it till you was able to rehearse it. You read it till you was able to write it down to what it means. You read it that it was in the front of your mind when you woke up the next day. That's true meditation. When you can take the word of God and begin to, you may have to get a, this is a big platform, so this is probably going to allow you to do it. Y'all see Bishop last week, he had a cover. Amen. You can add your dictionary, and you can get your iPad on your phones, and you can Google some stuff. You can get a concordance from your mom and your daddy, just so you can understand what the scripture is saying. That's meditating in the word of God. It goes beyond reading.
Amen.
When you're in school, when they tell you to read something and write a book report about it.
Right.
In order for you to write a book report about it, you gotta read it and understand it. Am I right?
Amen.
Amen. Am I right, young people? In order for you to be able to write about it, you got to understand what you're reading. You can't just read it one time and think you're going to be able to get a 3-page book report out of it. Or a 3-page paper is not going to happen. You got to keep going back and keep referencing that book. You got to keep going back and you may have to reference another book so you can understand what happened in the historical fact of that book. Amen. So that's what God wants to do with his word. He wants to just take his word and you may have to just play it on your phone and just let the word just rehearse in your mind. Meditate. Because when you meditate on it, when you get the word deep down on the inside of you, and I promise I'm going to move on in a minute, but when you get the word deep down on the inside of you, you're able to take note of that word, and you're able to follow that word through and be obedient to the word that you've got on. Somebody say, meditate.
Meditate.
Meditate. Because in this, when you do that, the scripture said, then thou shalt have good success. Then your way will be prosperous. Why? Because not only did you study the word, not only did you read the word, but you began to apply the word in obedience to God. So now God's saying, hey, I can just lay it all out for you. Because you're ready to go forward. Yes, you're going to have some battles, young people. Don't get me wrong. The enemy ain't slick. That's why you gotta cover yourself in the blood. So because while you can't see what's gonna happen in your day, God already knows. See, Bishop always tells us God is in our tomorrow before he gets there.
Yeah,
amen. So we just got to get in God so we can be ready when the enemy shall approach. Amen.
Amen.
So you may have somebody that's going to tease you, or you may have somebody that's going to try to bully you or try to punk you or whatever. You're going to have that. Amen. But just know who you are.
Right.
Just know that you're strong and you're very courageous and you're obedient to the word of God. You're a blessed child. And God's got you covered. No matter if you're going to a new school, a new grade, amen. You don't have to worry. You don't have to be nervous. God got you covered.
Right.
You may say, well, come on, I ain't going to have no friends. I'm going to this school, and I don't know nobody. I don't know. I don't know if I'm able to do it. Yes, you will. Yes, you will. To be courageous, another word for courageous is to be brave. You got to put on the strength of the Lord. Let me give you a Bible story real quick. Amen. And we're going to move on. Let's think about David. David. Somebody say David.
Amen.
What was the giant's name that he went up against?
Goliath.
I can't hear you. Say it again.
Goliath.
Good job. Good job, Sunday school. Good job. Good job. So David went up against Goliath. In order for David to go up against Goliath and really win and really defeat the giant that was facing him, the one that defied the name and the people of the Lord, he had to be courageous. He had to be brave. He had to be strong. Strong in who? He had to be strong in the Lord, in the power of his might. In order to be able to stand up and say, who is this uncircumcised Philistine that he would defy the name of the Lord? Who do you think you are? He took on the courage of the Lord. He took on the power and the might of God. And he began to stand up, and the Lord gave him strength, and the Lord gave him ability to defeat the giant, the lion that everybody else was scared of. So young people, you don't have to fear. God has given you everything you need to survive and move forward. And the next point I'm going to bring, and I'm almost there. Don't be afraid of your journey. And I think that could be for some of us adults as well. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid to succeed. Sometimes we get a little nervous. You know, when things are going right, we look for something to mess up.
Yeah.
We say, it's going too right now. And that's really how it's supposed to be. We just, sometimes we get a little nervous about succeeding and about being prosperous in our journey as we walk this walk and talk this talk for the Lord. But don't be afraid of your journey, missionary. Don't be afraid of your journey, evangelist. Don't be afraid of your journey, people of God. Hallelujah. Because where God is taking you, He's got you covered. What He got for you, He got you covered. The journey that you got that you have to go on, He already mapped out the way. Oh yeah, He know you're going to come up against some tribes and some people that think they're going to come up against you, but you're already covered in the blood. However, hallelujah, you already got the war that you already got what you need for war. So don't be afraid of the journey. It may seem unfamiliar. It may even seem uncertain. Going to the next grade seems uncertain. It's going to a new school seems unfamiliar. I'm not going to know nobody. I may not be able to find my class. I remember when I got ninth grade in high school, I couldn't even get into my locker. And if you ever went to Sula, you got two buildings. Imagine your first year at Sula and your class is in the annex building. You don't even know what the annex building is. So it's unfamiliar, it's uncharted territory. You've never been there before. But once you jump in there and begin to realize, hey, this is not hard after all. You mean to tell me that I actually can go to school and be successful? I can actually go to school and make a wage. I can actually go to work and get promoted. I can actually go to work and get a raise. I can actually go and influence somebody else to be saved in the kingdom. I can actually go and empower somebody else. You can do it. We have to be strong and be very courageous. We are the people of God. We live in a world where things are going crazy every day. Oh, but God got us covered. Hallelujah. He got a plan already mapped out for us. He got us covered. He got us covered. We just got to follow Him. It's just that simple. We just got to follow Him. Don't lean to the left. Don't lean to the right. Don't go away from what you was taught. Don't go away from what you received in prayer. Don't go away from what you received in that song. What God spoke to you through your pastors. Don't go away from that. But let's say, don't go away from what your parents taught you. Stay in that narrow line, that narrow way. And keep on going to success in God. So we just got to know that God is with us. No matter what. No matter what goes on in this world, no matter what type of organization trying to do whatever and whatever school, we got God. We got the power in the name of Jesus backing us up. We got the blood of Jesus covering us. As a matter of fact, when the children walk through the schools and they're already covered in the blood, every step that they take is covered in the blood. Hallelujah. Every classroom they go in is covered in the blood. Why? Because the child of God is there. So wherever they go, they're blood covered. Hallelujah. And the friends ought to be grateful that a child of God is in their midst. Because that means the presence of the living God is in the room. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Wherever we go, hallelujah, the presence of God goes with us. Wherever we go, the blood of Jesus goes with us. So we don't have to be afraid of the arrow that flies by day or the terror by night. Because God got us covered. Isaiah 54:17 says, "What? No weapon formed against us shall prosper." It may be formed to come against us, but it's not going to prosper. Meaning anything to try to deter you or just try to distract you from doing the right thing is not going to work.
Amen.
It's not going to work. I've got my mind made up. It's not going to work.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So give it your best shot. Thank you, Jesus. Because God gave me His best. Hallelujah. And as I'm studying, I'm coming to a close. And I thought about it, how the Lord really emphasized to Joshua to be strong, be courageous, be brave. You know, yes, you got a promise. You're going to get to the promised land in 3 days. You're going to do it. You're going to succeed. You're going to graduate high school. You're going to graduate from the grade that you're in. You're going to get the honor roll, but you got to be strong going in. You got to be courageous going in. Yes, you want to, that child of yours or that spouse or that family member or that friend in the family that seem like they don't want to be saved, they're going to be saved. But you got to be strong going in to witness to them. You got to be strong. You got to put on a brave face. Amen. You got to be courageous. Put your head up. Get your shoulders back. It's time to go to war. It's time to go to war. Because he knows the way that I shall take. Job 23:8-10 says, "Behold, I go forward, but he is not here. I go forward, he's not there. And backward, but I cannot perceive him. On the left hand, where he doth work, but I cannot behold him. He hides himself on the right hand, that I cannot see him. But he knows the way that I take. When he has tried me, I shall come forth as gold." He knows the way that I take. He knows where I'm going. He gave me a purpose before I was even here. Amen. So he knows which way I'm going to go. And sometimes you're not going to feel him on this side. Sometimes you may not feel him on that side, but you got to know that God is with you. Because he knows the way that I take. So I can't stop worshiping. I can't stop praising. I can't stop seeking him in prayer. I can't stop coming against strength. Because God knows the way that I take. And I need every instruction that he has to give me, because he got me covered. So as I close out, young people, I want to encourage you to be strong. Be of a good courage. Be strong. Be very courageous. Meditate in the word. Observe to do what's right. Practice doing right. There's nothing wrong with doing right. Amen. And the Lord gave me a little prayer, amen, a little declaration. Amen. I asked the usher, Little David, somebody to pass them out to all the young people. Amen. That we can say together, glory to God. Because we are strong. We are courageous. Yes, you get it. You can jump on your feet. You can jump on your feet. You can jump on your feet, especially our youth, jump on your feet. Amen, jump on your feet, hallelujah. Jump on your feet, glory to God. While you jump, can somebody shout hallelujah? Can somebody shout hallelujah? Glory to God. Just the Lord gave me this word for our young people that's going back to school. Amen. And while I'm here, keep our college students, let's keep them in prayer, amen. And they will observe to do what is right, and they will stay focused. And they may be successful and prosperous in their educational goals, amen? And the goal of serving the Lord and bringing their souls to the kingdom. And this back to school declaration is based out of Joshua chapter 1, amen? 7 to 9, I should say 7 and not 2, 7 through 9. And I want you to repeat after me, say, I am strong. We're going to say it like we. I want y'all to make the chandelier shake. I am strong.
I am courageous.
I am not afraid.
I'm not worried.
Because God is with me. All right, so I'm just going to say I am. I want you to fill in the blank. I am what?
Strong.
Next line. I am what?
Courageous.
Next line. I am what?
Courageous.
Next line. I am what? Because who is with me? Who is with me? Amen, amen. Just a little declaration, young people, you can say to yourself, when you get to school and you may seem nervous or the test may seem hard, just tell yourself, I'm strong, I'm courageous, I'm not afraid, I'm going to face this giant, because God is with me. Amen, we can all stand if you're not standing. And this time there may be one that don't know about God being with them. The altar is open. Amen. If you're not saved in this in the room, if you don't know God as your Savior, if you don't know that God is with you, if you really don't know that God is with you, come on down to the altar. Amen. Amen. We're going to ask all our young people to come on down as well as we pray over them for going back to school. And also, if you were not here yesterday, we do have some book bags left, please. Amen. We'll give you a book bag when you leave today. If you were not here yesterday, to get one. If you got one, amen, you have yours. Amen.
I speak courage, God. I speak
just alter. I speak obedience at this altar, God. In the name of Jesus Christ. Call the scholarship, Lord God. Grace, God. Free money, Lord God, for success. Oh God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Cause them to prosper for the grain therein up until their dome, God. In the name of Jesus Christ. And God, we thank you. Bless our parents, God. Give them patience, God. In the name of Jesus Christ. Give them the strong discernment, God, to see what their child is going through, Lord God. In the name of Jesus Christ. Help them to walk there for their children, God. In the name of Jesus, oh God, we thank you. God, we praise you. We thank you. We praise you. We give you glory, oh God. Bless our college students, God. Bless our college students, God. Every college, every university, God. The one that's in the military, the one that's in trade school, God. In the name of Jesus Christ. And God, we thank you. We praise you. Cover in the blood. Cover, God, in the blood. Cover in the blood. Cover the mind in the blood, God. In the name of Jesus Christ. We live in perilous and dangerous times. But God, we know you're able to keep us, God. And the one that may be here for healing or salvation or deliverance, Father. Oh God, we know that you're able to do it, Father. And we thank you for it now, God. In Jesus' mighty name, we thank you. Amen and thank God.
Children, we will be praying, praise God, for where God's going to take them, that path
praise God, because the enemy is going to be trying to come and sidetrack that. And all the people, you know what I'm talking about, because some of you are not doing nowhere near what you started off wanting to do.
Yeah.
And I'm right about it.
Yes, sir.
And then you got to that place where you begin to settle in, and you begin to accept it where you are, and you just left life right where it is. Amen. Praise God. But the prayers of a righteous avail us much. And I see great things taking place, praise God, into the hearts of people. I see great things taking the hearts of our young people, praise God, being the future endeavors. And if you don't empower them, if you don't empower them with the truth, praise God, and then with all these things that's coming forth, praise God, these Minister Maddox spoke about, they're going to be indicted with all this other negative stuff, and it's going to get into their spirit, and they're not going to have the truth to be able to discern if it's all right. It's going to seem right. There's a way that seems right unto man, but the end of destruction, and they will come to accept the knowledge of these things and begin receiving to their spirit man and begin saying, it's all right, but it's not all right. And at the end of the day, it will lead them to destruction. Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord. God is good. He's simply worthy to be praised. Praise God. I want you just to stand with me one more time, and we want to pray for all the young ones that's away in college. Many of ours have moved to college in this cycle. Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord. You got the dancing girls. You got Monique. You got Carol and Caleb. Amen. Somebody call out the names. Shannon. Manny. David. Ariana. Hallelujah. Bishop. Amen. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name. God is good. He's something worthy to be praised. And we need the prayers of the righteous. We need the prayers of the righteous. We need prayer, praise God. I don't want us to get so off track that we don't believe in prayer. And amen. Blessed be the name. On that we begin to battle, and then it seems that we can fight this resistance and be going through because we don't place it in prayer. I'm telling you, God wants to be successful, but there's areas, fundamental things that we need to do in our lives to become successful in the thing that God has called us in. Amen. It's not going to be a catwalk. It's going to be a fight. Praise God. But how do you know that we're going to win? It's already written. Praise God. Could we still lift up those that are away in college, those that are away in the military, Z and G and K, and what's the name? K, J, G, Nick in the back, Lorena's son, Carlos, amen, your son, Lisa. Amen. It's a whole bunch of them. We need to, I want the names on the prayer list. Every day we're going to be lifting them up in the prayer when we go into prayer. They're going to need this. They're going to need more than just a book bag. They're going to need prayer.
Yes,
amen. They're going to need prayer. Praise God. It's going to go with them. And we're lifting their names up in prayer. Praise God. When they meet that challenge, when they meet that crossroad where their thoughts are challenged with things, praise God. Even if they walk into a place they don't supposed to be, praise God, even the servant man will say, you don't belong in here. You see what I'm saying? Have you ever experienced that? But you don't belong in here.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. I remember a story about my brother. He went to a bar and he started speaking, and the man said, you a preacher, you a evangelist, you're speaking right to my soul. But God is good. He's simply worthy to be praised. Praise God. So we want you to know, praise God, the power of God is working. Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Praise God. So we lift those names up. Praise God. Father God, in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, Lord, the names that we have lifted up into the atmosphere that we have called out, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Lord. Praise God that you will meet them where they are, Lord. We pray, Lord, praise God, that they will spiritually prosper in you. That the home for your truth and your word will always be there, that they will take the knowledge that they're receiving, praise God, and lace it with your truth, praise God, and move forth, Lord, in life, Lord, to be an impact into this dying world, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Lord, we pray, Lord, for their provision, Lord, that you will provide for them every step of the way, make ways out of no ways, Lord, move scholarships, move things around, praise God, move favor in their lives right now, Lord. In the name of Jesus, Lord, we just thank you right now, Lord. Lord, we pray for their discernment. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. That they will have keen discernment, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Lord, they will be able to recognize wrong and right from afar off. Lord, that they will be able to see things, praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God before even come in their path. Lord, we pray, Lord, that you would minister to the hearts and the dreams and their thought patterns, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Lord. Lord, praise God, Lord, they will recognize when they need to call for help. Praise God, and reach out, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Lord. Praise God, we just pray, Lord. Praise God, for we know, praise God, that you're interceding on the behalf of the right hand of the Father, Lord, for their success. Lord, we just thank you right now, Lord, that you will have your way. Lord, we plead the blood of Jesus right now. Have your way, Lord, praise God. And those that in their crossroad, Lord, not sure with uncertainty in their life, Lord, in the next grade that they're stepping into, Lord, praise God, we pray, Lord, that you give them a supernatural power of comfort in their spirit, Lord. Give them that confidence in you, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Lord. Praise God. We just thank you right now, Lord. In your name we pray, Father, Lord. We lift you up and we thank you right now. In Jesus' wonderful name we pray. Amen and amen. Praise God. God bless you all. Praise God. Bless you all. Praise God. Without having their name, praise God. Praise God, Ella Hawkins. We make sure you have that sheet for the intercessory prayer. Put it on that sheet. Blessed be the name, Lord. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. We want those names on that intercessory prayer to be translated. We assume to all that intercessory that is continually laid in prayer. The covenant, praise God. It's the covenant of that what God is going to do. It's that covenant. It's that covenant. It's that covenant. Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord. He's worthy to be praised. Somebody's coming on my left. Amen.